Did your people have a spread outside of town back in the days before the Civil
War?
Yeah, my great-great-grandfather moved from North Carolina and built this farm with his parents. Actually, it was my people who built it. You see, I come from the line of slaves. Your great-great-grand built your dreams together, and then those dreams turned into nightmares for us. I super outline everything before I write it. Every page is outlined. The characters are well defined. What's interesting is you get 75 to 100 pages into the book, the characters take the story away from you and start to write it themselves. You find out you have them doing things they wouldn't do. You also find out your characters are a lot more interesting in some cases than you thought they were, so they suddenly have bigger roles in the book than you thought they did. Ultimately, you know where the story's going to end, but sometimes the road between that beginning and that ending goes off track. And so you're writing stories that tend to take you to places as an author you didn't expect to go. And I think that's one of the most interesting things. And in Coop Lindsay, the lead character, he was fascinating. I got to know him well. I hated to put him away. Because at the end of the book, when you actually had to close it and quit writing his life, he had become a very good friend of mine. And there's a black woman in her 50s in 1964, a maid named Hattie Ross. And I captured her dialect by talking to people. And I can still hear the words of wisdom that Hattie was telling the people around her at the same time. Those words of wisdom, I think, stuck with me too. So the process of writing is about outlining and then suddenly the rewriting, yeah, you do it six times, but the writing of the book itself starts taking on a rhythm thanks to the characters you invent.